Welcome to Govt Post viewers. The Confederation of Indian Industries and the Tamil Nadu Private School Association has submitted a report on Syllabus Enhancement Recommendations 2017 to the state government. So today we have with us Mr. C.R. Swaminathan, member, National Council for Higher Education, CII, and Mrs. Visalakshi, President of Tamil Nadu Private School Association, to talk to us about the recommendations. So my first question is to Mr. C.R. Swaminathan. Sir, did it take NEET and the suicide of a Dalit, poor Dalit girl, for us to really, think about a revamp of syllabus? Where were we wrong?
The thing is, initially, for the last very many years, the state government has not taken steps in revising our syllabus, is okay. One. Second, I won't say that Dalit student suicide is due to our syllabus being weak. There are so many other reasons. But as far as our syllabus of school education is have been, when compared with CBSE, have been not that high. And our education system of passing the students up to 8th standard, automatic promotion, and having exam on 12th exam, giving importance to 12th exam and scoring of marks. So student, without understanding what it is being taught, he was mugging up and they were writing exam. So when analytical type of questions had been posed to them through NEET, they were not able to perform well.
Right. So so this is for Madam Visalakshi. Ma'am, tell me, they said that Samachir would bring a level playing ground because the corporation schools would otherwise not be able to match matriculation. And, any which way they wouldn't be able to match matriculation. So they made matriculation also Samachir. And that, it is believed, it brought the quality of education to a great, brought it down to a great extent. So what do you have to say about this? Why are we not being able to decide on how our education system needs to be?
So that only if schools are given autonomy.
Okay.
Like how universities and some colleges are given, it'll be a fair ground. But of course, when Samachir was brought into, that was what in private institutions are playing with the matriculation syllabus, and we are making money out of it. That was the accusation on private schools.
Right.
And we were frequently applying to the government that if you are going to do Samachir syllabus, let it be Samachir, but let the matriculation syllabus be taken to the government schools. That was what we were repeatedly asking the government to do.
Yes.
And you do a pilot study. See, it's initially the 10 years of syllabus you can't dump on the government school.
Right.
And in actuality, what really happened was, whatever the matriculation students...
Because the government school students, it's enough if they come, even if it is for one day, they are promoted to the next class. So it is impossible that they will be able to handle matriculation syllabus in corporation schools, am I right?
No, but that happens, not every day doesn't happen, and all the children are not like that. There are regular children.
Okay.
When we talk about syllabus, they learnt it in the Tamil medium and the matriculation schools learnt it in the English medium. That was only the big difference.
Okay.
And the content was a little bit high in the matriculation syllabus. We had first paper in two papers in mathematics, science we had two papers. Hmm. We had a regular practicals. That was a major difference.
Okay.
And languages, yes, English was at a higher level. Tamil book was the same for government school and the private school.
Okay.
So maybe English and maths and science, if they've upgraded, it would have been better. But they didn't do that.
Okay.
They were talking about Samachir, and they downsized everything.
Right.
And they, even whatever already the government schools were learning also was downsized. Only the medium was different actually.
Absolutely.
That also was downsized. Science was made literally into zero.
Okay.
And it is nearly 9 years now since the Samachir syllabus was introduced.
Okay.
And that is what has happened today.
Okay, hold your thoughts, ma'am. Sir, you tell me, talking about the medium of instruction. So if English is thrust upon everybody, do you think we will play a level playground?
Oh, definitely. But anyhow, the NEET exam also, Government of India has given clear direction that it can be even in the regional languages.
Hmm.
But my point is, if the syllabus is framed in such a way where the student can, at least 25% of the syllabus can be an analytical thing, the student will be in a position to understand what he is studying, what for it is, and he'll be in a better position to appear for any competitive exam, not only NEET, any exam.
Okay.
So the language is not a thing, but if we want to compete with other states, we should concentrate more on English language, whereas Tamil also should be given importance because as a mother tongue, it can.
That's a regional language. Yeah. Okay. So, Madam Visalakshi, you tell me now. There have been certain recommendations that you have given to enhance the syllabus this time. So, what are they? Very briefly, tell me the important ones.
Now, initially, we thought that Tamil should be a little bit downsized. English is already downsized. And the higher education, like 10th standard, 12th standard, all the content is quite less. So, children easily get marks in English. But Tamil, because it is overburdened, too many detailed answers and the content is very heavy. So, we had suggested to reduce the content.
Which class?
Particularly for 10th, 11th and 12th, board exams, board exams. Because lower classes also it is voluminous.
Okay.
But yes, they can omit some part and they can pass on. But when it comes to 10th, 11th and 12th, they have to write too many detailed answers. So that was one suggestion we have made.
This is part of the second language, where if Tamil is a second language.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
But it is called the first language here.
Okay.
It will be the first language. English will be the second language.
Okay. Okay. So, coming back to the recommendations.
Yes, apart from that, we had asked for first paper and second paper in mathematics also, because initially matriculation, it was like that. We had a first paper and second paper. The ultimate reason behind it is the children will go in depth into the content. When you go for 100 marks, it is again selective learning, 60% they learn, 40% they'll omit, but in spite of it, they'll be able to get good marks. But if it's first paper and second paper, in spite of marks being the ultimate goal, then knowledge, even an average child will get better knowledge.
So which means the number of subjects will go up.
Not the subjects, maybe the papers. Number of papers
max
only.
One, max two.
But the knowledge of the child is what is very important.
Okay.
It is not that he should get 100 in first paper and again 100 in second paper. Even 60 marks in first paper and 60 marks in second paper, because maths and science is very crucial.
Okay.
Languages, yes. And again, social studies is only going to be till 10th standard. But maths and science will go to till his higher education.
Okay.
So it will be good. Again, science also made into first paper and second paper, like physical science and biological science.
Okay.
And practicals given more importance, because in summer chair we had at least 50 marks for each paper, 50 for physical science and 50 for biological science. But now it is totally for science only 25 marks practicals in 10th standard.
Okay.
So again, the in-depth knowledge of the child in science also will automatically go down, because three papers he is going to write for 75 marks.
You tell me. The problem with Indian education is that we don't, there's nothing much which is given in terms of conceptualizing. You know, there's no analytical, logical thinking. So, have you recommended anything on those lines?
Yeah, we have in our syllabus, we have made it compulsory that minimum 20 to 25% should be analytical.
Okay.
But for which we have to train our staff also.
Right, absolutely.
Only then.
So what is the standard of the staff currently? What have you evaluated?
No, we have not yet done that. We have only given the syllabus revision.
Okay.
And we have to go in for staff.
Okay. Okay. Ma'am, you tell me, will our, you have furnished the syllabus. Do you think our corporation school teachers will be able to manage these, this kind of a syllabus?
See, any teacher can handle the syllabus. Syllabus handling will be only teaching the children in the classrooms.
Okay.
And just the right way of teaching should be taken to the teachers. And ultimately, examination decides the teaching in the classrooms. How we are going to evaluate the children finally, that speaks in the classroom. So evaluation, if it is changed, because today you know the board exams, rote memory, repeated questions,
right,
blueprint, PTA, all that is ready-made. And the child knows at least 70% what questions will appear in the exam.
Absolutely.
So when the child knows the question paper, he learns only for the question paper. He doesn't learn for knowledge.
Right.
So that is why the teachers are also trained to train the child accordingly.
Yeah.
So evaluation changes, and even if the teacher doesn't know what is going to be asked, then content will be taken to the classroom.
Right.
So that will be the one magic to be done. Evaluation. You change that, everything will change here.
Okay. How employable is your current syllabus? I mean, because I think we've been lagging behind when it comes to employment. The students who pass out, a very few percentage of them are employable, and that's been the survey and study. So how employable are the students who will study this rehauled syllabus?
In the older system, the thing is, the syllabus, whatever it was taught only to score marks. The students were mugging up without even understanding the subject and scoring marks. So when they come to college also, if you see engineering colleges, the students who complete engineering, as per NASCOM study, only 20% are employable,
right.
80% are unemployable. It is the same because of the foundation. At the school level, we have mugging up. The same thing continues in the college level also. So now with the present syllabus, we also recommend at about 8th standard or so, to, if possible, to do a psychometric analysis of each student and find out what is their talent, interest, so that we encourage them to take that subject. If they are not interested in studying main science and math subjects, let them do some vocational education and be ready for the jobs. Similarly, if they are interested in medicine or engineering or economics, sociology, psychiatry, something like that, they, depending upon their interest, they can study so that they can be employable.
Okay.
That is what we are planning.
Okay. Okay. So does this mean that the syllabus, the children who study the syllabus will be NEET prepared?
Of course, but again, NEET preparation should be integrated along with the syllabus. Again, NEET is also it is a exam where it is 1 marks again, and it is not the theory based.
Right.
Of course, they are going to go for the board exam. The content of NEET is there, but again, we have to train the child also to go for that competitive exam, not only for NEET, other competitive exams also. So, if the competitive exam training is also integrated along in the school itself with the subject teacher, if the subject teacher is trained to teach the child for NEET, it will be good.
And that will be outside school?
No, that is what I'm telling, integrated along with the subject.
Along with the subject.
So when they learn for the 1 marks, they can learn for the NEET 1 marks also. NEET is also 1 marks.
Okay.
So that is done. This coaching centers and all will not thrive.
Flourish. Right, absolutely. So, so my final question to you is, the naysayers of the NEET have to say that Tamil Nadu has produced phenomenal doctors even before NEET. So what do you have to say about that? They say that NEET is not necessary.
You see, the government of India would like to see a standard to be maintained throughout the country.
Okay.
And because they do not want the private medical colleges to make money, charge capitation and so on and so forth. So purely on merit, they would like to standardize and select. For which, because each state has a different pattern of syllabus and other thing. So to have one common exam is NEET that they have recommending. So I think we have learnt a lesson last year.
Right.
So with the revised in syllabus, in another 2 years time, our students also will be on par or even better at the national level to secure.
Okay. Thank you so much for talking to Govt.
Thank you.
Thank you.